Hi guys, my name is Crystal. Welcome to my YouTube channel. This is a follow on from the other video. Alexa, good morning.
Good morning. On this day in 1998, sex in the city debuted on US television, and a generation lived vicariously through Carol's New York exploits, honor of romances, and seemingly never ending wardrobe.
She's talking about Sex in the City, the American TV program, which had films as well, Sex in the City. Alexa, celebrity birthdays.
Today's famous birthdays include American football player, wide receiver DeAndre Hopkins, British actor Jason Isaacs, American actor, voice actor, singer, and director Robert England, American internet personality and actor Ryan Higger, and American guitarist, songwriter, and producer Steve Vai.
Alexa, who is Robert England?
Robert Barton England is an American actor and director, best known for playing the supernatural serial killer Freddy Krueger in the Nightmare on Elm Street film series.
Alexa, how old is Robert England?
Robert England is 76 years old.
Well, he's nearly as old as my mother. Right, so I was saying that I said, Mum, why do you call me nearly six times a day? And she said, I care about you, Janestra. She doesn't call me Crystal. She's making it out to be unlike my father. I change my names and I've got different aliases. I haven't. Yes, I was born Janestra Trower. I changed my name to Crystal Marshall in 2009 and I've been Crystal Marshall ever since. I chose to change my name and my father helped me, right? There is a deed poll somewhere that the NatWest Bank has got and they won't return to me, so I can't get a passport. However, I have my original birth certificate under the name of Janestra Trower, and it says I was born a female child. I was born in Lewisham Hospital in London. So I said to my mum, I said, why do you keep ringing me? She says, I care about you, and you said you get depressed and upset. And she was calling to make sure I was okay. So I said, will you do me a favour, Mum? I said, you know, I'm an adult, I'm 54. I said, ringing me once a day at the most, or once a week, because it's not necessary. It's wasting your phone bill, because she's ringing from a landline to a mobile, which is wasting her money. I said, if I need you, I will call you. And if I'm worried about you, I will call you. So she's managed to lay off the phone yesterday. So yesterday, she didn't call me in the afternoon. She didn't call me in the evening. Yes, I suffer from depression, but I am an adult, right? And there are other people in my life, other than my mother, that I can turn to as well. She's got her own life, she's got her own problems, she's got a lack of mobility, she doesn't get out, Jennifer doesn't, and she's got neighbours that go in to see if she's okay. So I don't really need to worry about that much, because I said, Sue comes in to you, and if you're in a bad way, Sue knows where I live because she's returned towels to my flat. So Sue, her neighbour, knows where I live if anything happens to my mother, which is fair enough. So yesterday I was round my mum's and she said that the Southern Housing had a chap round her address at Double Gardens and he was a very nice man and they're coming to do her bathroom at Double Gardens. They're not doing mine because mine is a new build flat. It's fairly new and it's got a bath and a shower unit and it's a big spacey bathroom, so I don't need my bathroom done anyway. I've got a shower curtain, a pink shower curtain. So that's good because my dad would not let my mum have visitors in the house. He would never have let Sue in the flat and he didn't like people coming in to the flat because he got jealous of people speaking to my mum. I'm Jennifer's daughter and I welcome the more people speaking to my mum the better. She's been suffered domestic violence, right? My dad trapped her indoors. So The bin men came round in their fluorescent suits because Doral Gardens bin day is Monday. So the bin men came out. My mum usually goes out to them and she didn't. She stayed indoors. We were talking about things and then what the usual happens. My mum gives me takeaway leaflets and a piece of paper and a pen and she asked me if I would like a takeaway. So there was a takeaway called Mexican, Khan, and my mum rang that and they weren't answering the phone. It said they were open from 11 a.m. to 12 midnight and my mum rang the phone 5 times and they didn't answer. So I was forced to use another takeaway, and the only takeaway that I really get on with is Super Pizza. And it's a regular bloke that really likes my mum. He likes my mother. I haven't even seen the bloke that delivers the Super Pizza. So this chap is a regular deliverer with Super Pizza and he likes my mother. They have a good old chat together and my mum's eccentric. And the guy seemed to be encouraging it. And I just sat in the chair because Jennifer is my mother and she was having a good old yap to the takeaway driver when he delivered it. And she said to the driver, "It's me, Jennifer, that's had a hard life," she said. "And there are some people that are trying to like copy me or something, but it's Jennifer that's had the hard life. The daughter hasn't." And I didn't get up. I didn't get up and I didn't get cross, I just sat there. It did upset me because my mother was talking about me really loudly to the taxi driver and she's like a big kid, and I questioned her afterwards, what did she mean? And she said, "Listeners hear no good of themselves. But when your mum speaks in loud decibels so the whole street can hear, it was meant for me to hear and it did upset me. I think we've both had a hard life." And when I say my mum's had a hard life, but she wants to compete. So she's had a worse life than me. Fair enough. I took that with a pinch of salt. The driver was having a good old natter with my mum while I was sat watching the TV. But I've been speaking to people on and off. I mean, it doesn't make me jealous. This is what my mum used to do to my dad. He used to get up off of the chair and go and see who she was talking to. But I'm not Derek. And if she wants to talk to a driver for half an hour, it doesn't bother me. Right, I'll show you the pizza, because I only ate one piece. This is a ham and mushroom pizza with garlic and herb sauce. This is their leaflet, Super Pizza's leaflet, and I ate a chicken burger and a corn on the cob, one corn on the cob and a chicken burger, and I had a strawberry cheesecake pudding, right? But I wanted the Mexican because the meatballs and rice sounded nice. The meatballs and rice, I wanted something that wasn't a pizza or a burger really. But the Mexican wasn't answering the phone, so I had Super Pizza instead. I just sat quietly. That's the best thing to do. When you feel people are siding with each other and getting against you, I mean, you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Yesterday it didn't work and I didn't rise to the bait. My dad used to get really angry. So I sat down, I ate my takeaway, my mum kindly did me some washing, I didn't hang it out on the line. She was talking about Veronica, the dark-skinned lady next door, putting her knickers on the line, telling me all the neighbour's business, personal, that I won't repeat. People's sexuality is their own sexuality, it's nothing to do with me. I was getting messages off Flirt Finder while I was round my mum's, which is a dating site, and they were asking me what underwear I had on whilst I was round my mother's. I was round my mother's, which was inappropriate. My mother had said someone was of a different sexuality, and I was getting rude messages on Flirt Finder. I sat with my mum till about, was getting on for 5 o'clock, when my mum rang a taxi. She was starting to get agitated, and not aggressive, but loud. And Jennifer's this, Jennifer's been through a hard time, Jennifer's the one that should, and she also said that someone is imitating her on Facebook, YouTube, and I got accused of copying my mother again, and then I just couldn't wait to get out of the door, and she'd ordered a taxi. The taxi arrived. It was a Polish sounding man, and he arrived at Durrell Gardens with the car wasn't fit for the road. It wasn't fit for the road, it was dangerous. My mum came out, she acted stupid, she went to make sure Janestra gets home safely, and the wing mirror was broken. I did question to the driver. I said, "Do you know what happened to your wing mirror?" He said, "I don't know what happened, it could be kids." And he said, "It's a rental car, and it's not up to him." So the car was broken. It was driving really slow, it kept stopping and starting, and the wing mirror was broken. The glass was shattered on the wing mirror. And I did manage to get home in one piece. I did. So you see, my mother calls me Janestra, she doesn't call me Crystal, and it sounds like Jennifer if you say it quickly. So she said the taxi's for Janestra, she said the wrong block, she said it was block 10 when it was block 7, and the driver that arrived was Polish, and the car was broken, it wasn't fit for the road. He kept stopping as if I was going to get my bags and get out and walk home with heavy bags, and I didn't. It was like play toys about, you know, cars on the pavement, and, you know, props. You know, when I was younger, I used to dance in the street, no word of a lie. You know, when you're happy and you've got your earphones on, like Madonna dances on top of a car. When I was younger, I used to jump over objects like props on a comedy show, because I used to be happy listening to music. It's been robbed of me. I had an injury to my ear and head, and I can't listen to music through earphones anymore, so I don't do that. I don't dance or anything like that anymore, because it's been robbed from me. So I can't listen to music through earphones. Anyone with headphones on or earphones is lucky, because I've been robbed of that. I've had damage to my right ear and jaw and head. But sometimes when someone hits you on the left, right, the right side of your brain can be damaged, and that's what's happened to me. Although I was hit on the left side of the head, all the pain and all the damage to my face has been on the right side. Because when I was hit, my jaw smashed together, my teeth broke, and something happened to my ear. Domestic violence is serious. Women die each day from domestic violence. It's not taken it seriously. Some women are thrown down the stairs and die in their own homes through domestic violence. Police are not sympathetic. They said they was going to red flag incidents up to me, and they never did. The police have, you've seen me film a police officer in my flat. They don't take anything seriously. They're like actors being stupid, dummies. And my mum said she might start writing again. Well, can I tell you that the diary that I wrote over 10 years was mine? It wasn't my mother's, and I'm not starting writing again. I'm not writing again. I'm not making money for other people. People like Holly Willoughby get their autobiography published and are paid for it. People exploit me for free. Fuck off. Fuck off. has been using me. She's been using me. My mother has been using me. I haven't got money. My bank has got about £1 in it. £1. My mum is probably feeling guilty, so she gives me money. But the diary was mine. The children I've lost weren't Jennifer's, they were mine. And I have had a hard life, but I want to make others aware that you can come back from anything. Don't give up, you know, carry on, because I'm going to battle this to the end and find out why every time I phone the police, they turn the tables and put it on me, and all my perpetrators are living more well off than I am, all of them. And when I complain, you know, the NatWest got a new carpet. When I complained about the NatWest, they got a new carpet. When I was living at Lansdowne Court with no carpet on the floor. Fucking sick of it. It's not good enough, and I want compensation for living with 12 years without my kids. And my dad died, never being arrested once after he attacked me and did things to me. And I'm not happy, no. I don't want to go out shopping. I want answers. And you better come up with them quick. See you later.